Harper and Harper Audio present Stinky's Stories Number 2, Jack and the Beanstink, by JJ and Chris Grabenstein. Read for you by the authors.
Chapter 1. An Unhappy Ending.
Hey there! I'm Stinky. Yep, that's my name. It's a good name for a stuffed skunk, don't you think? Right up there with Cheese Butt. The lady reading the story to my friends down on the rug? That's Mrs. Emerson. She's the Hickleberry Elementary School librarian. She's the sweetest person in the whole building. Today, Mrs. Emerson was reading a classic to the kids, Jack and the Beanstalk. You know, the one about the kid who swaps his cow for a handful of beans and then climbs a magic beanstalk into the clouds where he finds a giant's castle filled with treasure and very large boots.
Jack grabbed the giant sack of gold coins, his golden singing harp, and the goose that laid the golden eggs,
read Mrs. Emerson. Yep, Jack was taking a ton of stuff that wasn't his. The big guy wasn't happy about it either. He chased Jack all the way back to where Jack's beanstalk poked through the puffy clouds.
Fee, fi, fo, foy, roared the giant.
Mrs. Emerson was doing her best giant voice.
I smell the stink of a very bad boy.
Anywho, as you probably already know, Jack escaped the giant and climbed down the beanstalk. The giant climbed down after him. Jack's mother tossed Jack an axe. Jack chopped down the beanstalk. The beanstalk creaked and teetered and fell. The giant tumbled from the sky and crashed to the ground. Ka-thud!
The end,
said Mrs. Emerson. She closed the book.
That's it? Asked a boy named Justice. He's a third grader.
Yes, that's how the story ends.
What happened to the giant?
I'm not really sure.
But Jack robbed him. Jack stole all that gold stuff. That's not a good ending, Mrs. Emerson.
Well, Justice, if you don't like how a story ends, you just have to use your imagination to create an ending you like more.
She stood up and had a big grin on her face.
Now, if you children will excuse me.
She walked away, but not until after she shot me a wink. Yep, I had work to do.
Chapter 2. Imagination to the Rescue.
The second Mrs. Emerson was gone, Justice raced over to my bookshelf and looked me straight in the eye.
I don't want the story to end that way, Stinky, he whispered.
Me neither,
said his good friend Abby. All the other kids, the ones still on the story rug, nodded. Everybody wanted a different ending. Yes, you caught us. The kids at Hickleberry Elementary can talk to us stuffies, and we stuffies can talk to them. Not all the time, of course. Only when there aren't any grown-ups close by. And only during regular library hours. Those are the rules. Plus, the kids all know not to tell anybody our secret. That would ruin the magic for everybody. Well, Justice, it's like Mrs. Emerson said. The story doesn't have to end the way it does in the book. Not if we use our imaginations.
Excuse me,
said Mr. Stuffington, the bear who can be stuffier than most stuffed animals.
I heard Mrs. Emerson say the words, the end. That means the story is over, done, finished. But,
said Wags the dog, panting eagerly.
She also said we could make up a new ending if we didn't like the one she read. I heard her. She said it. Oh, yes, she did.
I heard her say that, too. So guess what, Justice?
What?
I'm going to tell you what happened after the giant fell to Earth. Mr. Stuffington rolled his eyes. Wags flicked his fluffy tail so fast it became a blur. And Justice? He looked even happier than Wags.
So the giant was okay?
Oh, yeah. Sure, he had a few bumps and bruises and some aches and pains, but he just took two aspirin the size of wagon wheels, which thankfully he had tucked in his pockets.
Wow. Those must be some very big pockets.
Humongous, just like Hubert.
And who, pray tell, is Hubert?
The 50-foot-tall giant who just fell out of the clouds.
The giant's name was Hubert?
Justice was smiling again. Yes, indeedy. Fortunately for Hubert, it had rained for several days before he...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.